In our previous session, we derived CP minus CV is equal to R. We were able to show this. And from this expression, you can see that CP is definitely greater than CV. By the time you're able to say that CV minus CV is equal to R, it means that CP is greater than CV. Now, of course, we know that CP is the specific heat capacity at constant pressure. CV or C subscript V stands for specific heat capacity at constant volume. And in this session, we are going to explain why CP is greater than CV coming up. Now let's take a good look at these two diagrams. In this diagram right here, we are having a gas. And in this gas, we'll call it a system, it's enclosed by a piston. But this is being held at constant pressure. And this right here is being held at constant volume. Now, if I subject this to some heat right here, because it is at a constant pressure, this piston will be pushed upwards, because the amount of heat coming in here is causing the intermolecular forces of attraction here to weaken, and as a result, this gas starts expanding. And as it's expanding, its pressure increases because of the kinetic energy increasing as well. So as its pressure tends to want to increase, this piston is pushed up so that it compensates for that increase. It accommodates that pending increase so that it keeps this system at a constant pressure. So for this to be at constant pressure, it would mean that as this is trying to go up, this gas does work as this gas expands upwards at constant pressure. Now, it means that the specific heat capacity at constant pressure requires that as heat is coming in, this heat coming in is first of all increasing the internal energy of this gas. But as it is increasing this internal energy of this gas, it is also doing work against the surrounding by pushing that piston up through probably a certain distance. Let's call that small distance dx. But then when we compare this kind of process where we hold the pressure constant, when we compare this process to this process where the volume is constant, the volume being constant means that this piston won't move up. This volume is static. This piston won't move. This volume is constant. So if this volume is constant, it means that all the amount of heat that is coming in here is only being used to increase the internal energy of the gas, and no work is being done by this gas. You realize that here, the amount of energy being fed in increases internal energy and does work. Here, the amount of energy coming in only does an increase in internal energy but doesn't do work. So you find that this is higher than that. So if I may conclude to explain these two phenomena, I would simply say that at constant pressure, the heat supplied is partly taken in to increase the internal energy, and then also it is used to do external work in increasing the volume of this gas. And at constant volume, there is no external work being done to increase the volume of the gas, and so the heat supplied here only increases the internal energy of this gas. And so that is why the specific heat capacity at constant pressure is greater than the specific heat capacity at constant volume. This CP, it's sometimes looked at as the molar heat capacity at constant pressure, and this is molar heat capacity at constant volume, or you call it the principal molar heat capacity at constant pressure, or the principal molar heat capacity at constant volume. This brings us to the end of this video. Thanks for watching. Feel free to check out other excellent videos on the channel, and don't forget to subscribe. For Kisembo Academy, this is Arnold Rangakuramia helping you manifest excellence.